Hello, Harv video audio stuff. Welcome back, good buddies. You may have noticed that over the last month or so, my videos look and feel slightly different. And there are a few reasons for that, but the most noticeable change has been my lighting rig in my workspace. And I thought you'd find it interesting for me to show you exactly what's going on and how I went from this to what you see now. Before I get into it, if you like that track, it's part of my royalty-free music packs. They're great, and they're linked below. So, lighting. My previous setup was a simple setup of an LED panel as my key light with probably not quite enough diffusion, a second LED panel facing up to try and bounce more light around the room, and then, it seems silly now that I'm reflecting on it, a set of fairy lights that were pinned on the wall above the camera and then draped to either side. It took me a little while to realise that I wasn't completely happy with the setup I was using, so I went about trying to level up my rig while spending as little cash as possible to achieve the look I was going for. In the end, I spent an additional £120, which is probably about $120 and euros, but I really think it was a worthwhile investment. The first thing I did was to move the ridiculous fairy light arrangement I had before. When you think about it, the cool thing about using fairy lights in video is when they're in the background of your shot. They actually can produce some really good bokeh balls, so obviously I moved them to the back wall, as far away from the camera as possible for maximum bokeh balls. Then I wanted to add accents of a few different colour temperatures around the room, so I started by picking up a steampunk style lamp with a very large Edison bulb, and I absolutely love it. The light is beautifully warm and it looks totally awesome. It's variable brightness as well, which is important because I need to be able to balance all of my lights around the room. To accent the other side of the room, I thought a cooler colour temperature would look good, and the ideal product to fill that role, bearing in mind that it will be visible in the frame, is a Westcott Ice Light, because the quality of light is great and the product itself will look good on screen. But whilst it's a good product, I just couldn't justify spending the quite large stack of cash that Westcott asked for it. Fortunately, I found a decent, far cheaper alternative. Sure, the light quality won't be near to that of the Ice Lights, but I don't need high colour accuracy for this light, as it's just lighting the background and not my skin. I'm not sure about its availability in other countries, so just check the link below. I'll do my best to have it linked there, plus all the other bits mentioned in this video. You may not have noticed this, but I also have a warm colour temperature strip of LEDs just here, just behind my computer. It's far from essential, but I quite like it because it gives a soft, warm glow through this gap and around this area here where there actually would have been nothing but shadow areas. Finally, I addressed my main key light and fill lights, which definitely could be improved. I kept the same lights, so I'm actually using two aperture LED panels, and the change I made to my key light was actually to increase the amount of diffusion by adding an umbrella, and of course, to use an umbrella, I also needed an umbrella holder. Not a problem, they're both super cheap to buy. But the difference of going from a very small diffused area to a very big one has been really noticeable. I'm now using my other LED panel in combination with the bounce to give me some fill light on my right hand side and just a little bit more bounce around the room, and it seems to do the job just fine. So there you have it, I went from a simple and honestly a little boring lighting setup to one which is much more cozy, colourful and interesting to look at, and with improved diffusion for better skin tones, all for not very much cash. Honestly, I could have done this without the Ice Light copy, and if I had, the whole overhaul would have only cost me around £45. /dollars/euros. And that's it for now. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. As always, I've loved making this video for you. And if you're still in the mood for more dope videos about video, I've made loads. I'll pop a couple of interesting ones on this side for you. And if you're not already subscribed, definitely do it. lots more good stuff coming. Just hit this blob right here. And until next time, let's help each other out and shoot better video. See you guys.